this week on a Pierce County News special.
Can you hear any birds?
Meet award-winning county employees. See innovation at work behind the scenes and improving services with technology. Hi, and welcome to a special edition of Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. We're taking you behind the scenes to meet award-winning Pierce County employees who are making a difference in our community. Each year, standing ovation awards are given to a few select employees for their innovation and leadership. Let's meet two women in the Parks and Recreation Department who are finding creative ways to care for young adults with disabilities.
Yeah, you ready? Roll! Vern and Ryan, welcome aboard.
Welcome aboard.
Welcome aboard.
And Lawrence, come here, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alrighty, gentlemen, we are set.
Today we're at the Nisqually Wildlife Refuge. And we're out just taking one of our field trips. We're out, we're getting to see the sites, we're getting out of the community center.
Yeah, he's taking a picture of you.
Yeah, why is he taking a picture of you, John?
Because you're so pretty.
Whoa, John, look at that, I can see through it.
What?
Can you see
through it? On the field trips, so honestly, just being out, they like to see the animals a lot. You think we'll see a river otter? I'd like to see a river otter.
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. What? Well, do you want to go over and see what it says?
Jen and I just really felt strongly that we need to provide a program for our transitioning adults. We have a camp called Camp Lots of Fun, and it serves individuals 6 to 21. Well, at the end of their camping experience when they're 21, many of our campers would cry and they'd have nowhere to go.
Can you hear any birds?
Yeah.
Can you hear them?
Yeah.
Because that's what it said, listen for birds.
The families came to us originally and said, you know, our kids are out of school. They don't qualify for going to Camp Lots of Fun any longer. What do we do? And so we developed Camp Pierce for kind of to meet that need, and there's a gap in that underserved population.
What really stands out is just the initiative and drive and passion that both Jen and Jen have for special needs kids, okay. Youth, young adults.
It's a good thing I brought my umbrella. It's keeping the rain away.
Work is kind of a loose term. We have fun and work comes out of it. They are funny. They are a bunch of comedians.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
They ask a lot of questions.
Do you get grounded sometimes?
No, I don't live at home.
I do.
So my parents can't ground me.
What about your husband?
No, he can't ground me either. Our participants are so eager to get out and do and try and participate, but it's hard to find other groups to work with us.
Duncan, my friend, you're making me nervous over there. Can you stay on the path? Thank you. There's a bit of a stigma with this group. I think going out into the community allows for not only our kiddos or our campers to have that experience of being out in the community, but it also gives the community members in general the opportunity to interact with our campers on just an everyday average kind of a trip and be, you know, in a fully accepting environment so that there's not really any bullying, there's no shaming, there's no embarrassment involved.
This group is hilarious and they are very lively and full of life, and I love coming and getting high fives from everybody and seeing the joy that they have just being out and about. And then we get back to our building and they'll say, God, that was so much fun. When do we get to do it again?
Oh my gosh, what do I get out of it? I love my job. It's the best job ever.
One, two, three.
Yay!
TGIF!
TGIF!
A group of ball field maintenance workers had a problem. When it rained in South Hill, their painted lines would wash away, and that chalk would head right for a nearby wetland. So the employees put their heads together and came up with this sustainable solution.
This is Heritage Recreation Park on Puyallup South Hill, and Pierce County Parks and Recreation operates this facility, and one of the things that they do here is they paint the lines for baseball and other types of field sports.
We're doing anywhere from 13 to 20,000 lineal feet
every 14 days of application. That's a lot of miles.
I already added the ratio of water, which we do a 10 to 1 ratio, so 10 gallons of water for every 1 gallon of chalk paint. Mixing up the paint with the trolling motor. After a couple minutes, it's good to go.
Chalk-laden runoff that was leaving the property and getting down into a wetland complex. That is pollution, and Pierce County is required to control that.
So we designed this new tank system in it, and as a result of that, now we do all of our rinse outs. We recover 100% of what waste, what used to go out into the field and off into the wetlands.
It's all about working together as a team and using each other's ideas. One person had the idea of doing it in like a large amount and then just kind of built off each other, and then someone else had another idea to add the motor.
They figured out a way to make that chalk last longer, and they were able to do it so that instead of using it every 7 days, they could put it down every 14 days, which saves a ton of staff time.
So for 6 soccer fields and 5 baseball fields, it used to take 2 guys a day and a half, and now it takes 1 guy 6 hours.
It'll be over $20,000 year end date versus last year. That's in labor and product material.
When we talk about sustainability, we're really trying to do 4 things. We're trying to save money, limit waste, protect the environment, and protect human health. I look at this project as a model project because it really does all 4 of those things.
And so what they did was this amazing homegrown solution to pollution.
So everybody's winning, including the taxpayer who sees a much cheaper cost for doing this work.
Doing laundry isn't just time-consuming, it's expensive. You pay to get the water, you pay to heat it, and then you pay to dispose of it, not to mention the detergent. So when Pierce County was looking for ways to cut costs in the county jail, it's no surprise they recruited Dean Paxson to examine the laundry room.
Pierce County Jail, they run the laundry 2 shifts per day and a single shift on Saturday and Sunday. They do about 5,000 to 6,000 pounds of laundry every day. We were looking at ways to save operation costs on the jail. The machines are large, they're 125 pound capacity, there's 4 of them, and that's a lot of laundry.
If we could decrease the amount of energy used to heat the water and decrease the amount of water wasted down to the sewer, there would be money to be saved for the county.
We're in the laundry room behind the washing machines, and this is the sump. This is when the washing machine goes in the spin cycle. The water is dumped into this trench here, and it's picked up by these pumps and sent back out to the sally port. Well, we're in the underneath the new jail, Pierce County, and this is the new laundry wash water recycle system that we just installed last November.
Dean was diligent and focused on making this project turn out successful. It had challenges. It is a challenging environment to do a project in. A jail as a 24/7 high security facility creates challenges for contractors and project managers.
And this is so-called the brains of the system, and this monitors the levels in the tanks and the flow through the filters. Out of the washing machine at the end of the spin cycle, and instead of sending that water to the sewer, it's sent back here where it's filtered, it's sent through a sand filter, activated carbon filter, and then it's disinfected ultravioletly, ozonated, pH is adjusted, and then it's sent back to the laundry for the next wash cycle.
Another benefit was that we actually end up with cleaner clothing at the end of the laundry cycle. It does a better job sanitizing.
We've recycled over 2.2 million gallons of water. That's water that didn't go down the sewer, and that's water that we didn't have to pay to reheat. We save about $40,000 a year, and that's from natural gas savings, sewage rates, domestic water, and laundry chemicals.
I think he could apply some of his expertise that he learned at work back to the home front.
I'm not allowed to do laundry at home.
presidential elections are the biggest elections the Pierce County Election Center handles. So to gear up, they hire hundreds of short-term workers to process all of those ballots. But adding all of those people became a payroll nightmare. Let's see how the auditor's office implemented a biometric time clock to save time and money.
Okay, one of two and two of two.
1222.
That was pick 21.
The process that we had before the biometric clock was people would sign a timesheet, so each individual, and we can have up to 400 extra hires here on one day. And say 100 or more would clock in at the same time. You can imagine the chaos with people writing their names on their timesheets, and then when they left at night, it was even more chaotic. Instead of standing in line waiting for someone to find their timesheets, they literally just wait to put their finger in the clock. It reads the capillaries in people's fingers.
So when they come in for the shift, they click, they hit the check-in, insert their finger in the machine, and it recognized my fingerprint and checked me in for my shift.
So we can run about 20 people through a minute, which is huge and fast.
Before, it took me about 10 hours to do payroll from the time I started entering everyone's payroll off the timesheets to the time I proofed them and approved them. Now it takes me approximately 45 minutes.
It saves her a ton of time in workday processing this time because it's automated and it's more accurate.
The extra hires just, they went with the flow and they're using it like it's been here for years. Julie Colacurcio has done a great job of setting them up, training them for this. It doesn't take very long to set them up, but once they're set up, it's just smooth. They love it.
If somebody has a problem clocking in, then I go out and help them make sure that the fingerprints are working, re-register another finger.
We went through a lot of testing, a lot of setup, a lot of people working real hard, and a lot of extra eyes being patient with us as we tested several clocks and got the settings exactly right.
That $10,300 investment is easily cost effective and purchased back. We estimated $9,500 of what we'll be saving, and it probably will be more because the general presidential is so large, and then it also has become something that's so successful we'll be able to do across the county.
Coming up next, meet a couple of managers whose practices are changing the way their departments deliver public services. We're back in just 60 seconds.
Control, then who is? Live above the influence.
Now you can see Pierce County from your phone or tablet with the new PCTV mobile app. Pierce County and City Council meetings, the weekly Pierce County News on PCTV, News Magazine Rainier Country, the topical discussions of Pierce County Talks, and all of the special programs in between. Download the app today and see Pierce County from here. PCTV, Pierce County Television. The Sewer Billing Division might not sound like the most exciting place to work, but this all-female team would beg to differ. Let's meet a manager whose leadership includes some interesting organizational practices in the workplace.
So right now we don't have the real parcels.
Right. We have one, we have the commercial and one SFR on the real parcel.
I see all of my staff as a role model in everybody here in my section. Each one of us brings something to everybody.
She leads by example. So if she expects you to be at your desk working at 7:30, it's because she's here before 7:30 working.
Pierce County Public Works, this is Heidi.
We answer about 3,000 calls a month. We do a lot of customer service.
Hey Heidi, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Good.
They work very hard and they help our customers in so many ways.
She's not the boss. She's part of the team. I don't look at her and see her as, this is Miss Malin, and then it's us here. It's all of us together.
So if anyone is looking to check out the P-card, if you could please direct them to Ruthie, and Ruthie's gonna be now the holder of that.
Anything anybody has a question on during the week or during that day can put a little sticky on the board, and then we'll talk about it.
You stick it, you own it, and you talk about it. There's no stupid questions. Put your sticky out there and let's talk about it, and if it needs more discussion, then we'll put it in the discussion.
She never lets you feel like your comment isn't a good one.
We just talk about what we have and we're done. And we say, have a great day. You know, it's very positive. Have a nice afternoon.
Yeah. There's no negativity. It's really, truly unlike any other place I really worked.
It was so refreshing when someone would go on vacation or, you know, on leave, and we could do their job. I implemented that everybody should be cross-trained, and we did rotational. And when that person comes back, you know, they're not so stressed out.
I like being able to know, you know, a little bit here and here and here to help everybody. Because the more you share and cross-train, the more you can help each other, and the more you are of a team.
They're the one who made me like this, made me feel like, you know, a leader. So, I owe it to them. I really do.
Mapping technology has drastically improved in recent years, and that made it possible for three departments to work together and create some interactive mapping software that's helping people every day.
So does anybody in your staff use this?
So just click on the parcel number.
The problem originally that we had that our customers faced was the fact that they had to go to many different systems in order to be able to see documents, recorded documents.
Recording numbers for easements and things like that.
You would have to go to one system to look up your parcel, another system to look up any deed information. Then you would take that information, go over to the auditor's office, and then pull the record and bring it back. If you're doing research at home, you're kind of jumping in between different screens.
What we really wanted and what our customers were asking for was a way to tie all that together and be able to go to the public GIS application, for instance, and be able to see the recorded documents. And it was a request that we got often enough that we knew it was really going to be very helpful.
By recorded document number or by the reference number?
All of the staff that listened to the customers, that communicated what they wanted, and it's just a good reflection on Pierce County, I think, and the customer service that we provide.
Behind the scenes, the technical side of it, we really streamlined the ability to make it easier for the general public to look at a map and click on a parcel number. It just made it really easy for the customer to be able to look at the documents, you know, that are specific to their property.
It's basically many kinds of deeds, liens, some excise tax information.
Having the relationship between the assessor's data and the auditor's office in a quick point and click, just a humongous time saver.
Everyone was very patient and understanding and knew the hurdles that we would have to go through. It took about 2 years to implement.
I've never received any standing ovation awards before. The award is great. I think it's a testament to the whole group that worked on it, our office, and just working together with all the people that were involved. It just made it really fun and it's good.
When the recession happened, the planning department was hit harder than others. There were big job cuts and a backlog of work. But with a new director and an infusion of new technology, we saw how the employees of Planning and Land Services turned things around.
This is the address off of Pacific.
PALS had been through the ringer.
When I first became county executive 8 years ago, one of the resounding responses from the public was they didn't like our PALS division.
He's aware of the situation.
They felt that the process was not customer friendly.
Budgetarily, we had lost 50% of our staff, and that's a huge morale hit. We had huge volumes of applications that were backlogged. We had unhappy customers.
I know that you give your best to this job in PALS, but unfortunately the public doesn't like you. They don't think you do a good job. And so I want you to aspire to be the best dam permitting agency in the state.
We started with some small process changes. We built success. One of the things that I've emphasized from the beginning is that if it doesn't work, we'll change it again.
As an employee, it's about streamlining what we do here and how we do it. It's about treating our applicants as customers.
Happy to do it.
We basically put, you know, ourselves in their shoes and say, you know, if we were trying to get a permit, how fast would we want to get responded to, you know, and how would we want to be treated?
So at what point do we need that report?
At any time.
Prior to submitting for a building
permit. Or you can submit it with your site development building permit.
The people that are building single homes, mainly that's what I work in, that I think is the most satisfying. And, you know, because a lot of times it's very daunting if you've never built a home before.
And we went paperless. From the standpoint of submitting applications, what we did was say that everything comes in electronically and then is managed as electronically as possible.
The other big change was going to our online code. You know, now folks aren't having to scroll through one huge section of code, and now it's linkable, searchable. And this is all urban zones, and this is all rural zones. And so we have it all in one place now.
A typical permit was taking upwards of 90 minutes. In fact, actually anybody coming in, it was about 90 minutes each. And so it was something to look at those systems and the processes and figure out how we could reduce that. And over time, we've actually reduced that down to the average time now is about 24 minutes. We've also gone to Skype inspections where we've able to reduce long trips out to the Anderson Island where you're waiting for a ferry or up in the Crystal Mountain area. We can do them with a Skype inspection.
Thank you. Can you tell me what that distance is between the two?
About half inch.
Okay, very good.
Make it faster, make it more understandable, make it more user friendly.
In 2007, we saw about 27,000 customers here and did about $6 million worth of permit revenue. Last year, we did about $6 million worth of revenue, and we only saw 11,000 customers.
It was the customers, it was the citizens, it was the master developers that came in and said, what happened? And the beauty of it was the same people.
I just love the fun atmosphere. It's fun working with customers, it's fun working with our staff. We enjoy what we do.
We hope you've enjoyed this special Pierce County News episode, meeting this year's Standing Ovation award-winning county employees. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. For more local focus, join us as we look back at memorable stories from 2016, beginning December 22nd here on PCTV. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.